this mono camera changes everything. The Touptek Astro ATR3CMOS 26000 KMA, and I'm so excited because I have now the opportunity to show you how great a monochrome camera really is for astrophotography. Since I started this hobby, I've been using a DSLR and then upgraded to a dedicated color camera, but these cameras can give the same quality as a true monochrome sensor, making this mono camera a game changer compared to cameras I used in the past. We have here the Touptek camera in a very nice case. Let's take it out. Oh, so nice, black armored case. So nice, we have some foam here. Here we have the camera, cables and charger. Okay, let's take out the camera. And here we have the cables. Here we have the charging cable. And here we have two adapters, an extension tube with another camera adapter here. I think this is M42. And on the back side of the camera, we have a USB 3 port, two USB 2, one DC 12 volts charging port. And on my first test, I experienced the amazing power of a monochrome sensor through narrowband filters. We have the Seagull Nebula captured in H alpha with a 7 nanometers filter using the ATR3 26000 KMA monochrome camera from Touptek Astro. I am really impressed with the quality. Look how clear it is. It do have some small hot pixels here, not too many, but minus 10 already is very good. We don't have a lot of hot noise, so the simplest way is just to go like minus 10 all the time. Or if you travel and you have a power source that is not so strong, you could go in somewhere at minus 5. But look, minus 10, and it works very good. After seeing the first deep sky results with this Touptek Astro mono camera, I regret not using a monochrome camera earlier. Even compared to my color Astro camera, which used the RGB version of the same sensor as the mono camera, I felt the mono version and my narrowband filters are generating now quality images that amazed me. The Touptek Astro camera of 26 megapixels met all my requirements. It uses the well-known 16-bit Sony IMX571 sensor that has no amplifier glow, even with long exposures. The large APS-C sensor is ideal for recording even larger nebulas or galaxies without needing to make a mosaic, and matches the sensor scale of my other cameras, so I can also consider combining data. The integrated and adjustable window heating prevents dew forming on the camera's protective glass, and it performs perfectly when imaging at minus 10 degrees Celsius. And this is important for a dedicated astronomy camera to have a good dew heater that will perform well without having any issues. I captured these images using a short focal length telescope, the TechnoSky 70-420, reduced at 360 mm focal length and f5 focal ratio. So this is a historic moment. I'm going mono with a large camera sensor. I'll do the first test with a TechnoSky apochromatic triplet 420 with a 0.85 reducer. And I'm using a filter drawer to be able to switch filters. Here we have a stunning image captured using a Bader 7 nanometers H-alpha filter, and the amount of signal in H-alpha was about 4 times higher compared with my color camera. After adding also oxygen 3 data, I was able to make an HOO image. I was amazed to see this level of detail and so good signal to noise ratio in a stack under 3 hours of integration time. This camera will also give you high resolution images and very sharp details. It will gather more light compared with a color camera because it doesn't have a Bayer filter. Let's see these beautiful details here. The Hart Nebula, let's zoom in. Look at these beautiful stars. This is the second exposure. We have round, sharp stars here. Look at the details here in the center. And we have below the Fish Head Nebula. We have an amazing resolution with this mono camera, 26 megapixels. And now we are imaging in H-alpha. Using this mono camera with the H-alpha filter helped me capture photons much faster. It's like using a faster telescope of f2.4 with my color camera. The increase in light gathering is similar with changing my telescope to a fast astrograph like RASA. I'm very excited to test soon with this mono camera a slower telescope like the SkyMax 127-1500 that I'm currently using it at 1650mm focal length at f13 focal ratio. By using this camera, instead of needing 6 minutes exposures to get a better signal to noise ratio, I should be able to get the same quality by imaging just 2 minutes or even less, and using a Maxutov telescope won't feel so slow anymore. Now let's see how the camera performs also on short image plans under 30 minutes using the H-alpha filter. The image quality was much better than every camera I've used in the past. We can see the results on the Horsehead Nebula and Rosé Nebula images. I was very impressed with the image quality that I was able to obtain in such a short time. This kind of result I couldn't obtain with the cameras that I've used in the past. I'll be able to get much better results in the same amount of time. We have also a beautiful capture of the Orion Nebula, 1 hour in H-alpha, that I edit another 20 minutes of data and convert it into a color image. After all these tests, I was very pleased using the Touptek Astro high-resolution monochrome camera that allowed me to capture excellent astrophotography images with my telescope setup. Touptek Astro impressed me with the build quality of the camera. Everything worked perfectly and I did not have any problems. I've made all the tests using Nina and I'm very excited to try it also with my other telescope on Galaxy Season. And I believe this is an excellent camera that can give you amazing astrophotography images. Another thing to consider when you buy a mono camera is also the price. Besides the camera, you need also other accessories like filters and a filter wheel that can cost a lot of money. The Touptek Astro mono camera is currently sold at a very good price, better than some other brands, and you can use the price difference to buy, for example, a set of filters that you can use with the camera. I was also happy to see that the good price of the camera did not compromise the quality, and after a month of testing, the camera worked perfectly without any issues. Stay tuned because I will share more results with this mono camera after I'll gather more data. I'll share also some of these quality images on the channel membership sharing folder. Don't forget to join the channel membership if you want to download and use my astrophotography data. Check also the description of the video for discounts and camera links and Touptek Astro Instagram and Facebook page to see more astrophotography images and special offers. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions and I will see you in the next video.